Hello, this is Linda from Scullywag Astrology, and this is a little run through on how to do some things in solar fire. So this is just a chart, it's a natal chart, and it's just with the standard of what I like to look at, but you can edit it to be whatever you want. Usually, if you haven't played around too much with solar fire, what you've probably got is the basic for the uni wheel, which is just like this, which is fine, but it doesn't give you very much. And you can go in here, there's some other options. Oh, didn't like that. A wide wheel, different things, but I want to edit it, so I'm going to get out of that one. I'm going to go back to the basic uni wheel, and I'm going to edit. So what I always do, I always get rid of this. Just right click on that and just put in a smaller one. So the brief or the boxed tends to be quite small. The boxed is really small actually, so we'll just put that up there. You can be quite strategic with this. You can see this is the width and the height and the anchor. So that's like, you know, looks like minus 0.01 probably from here, and this anchor from down, I suppose. I don't mess with that much myself. I usually just move them around, and then if you want to, you can usually come along and mess with them further. This is the font size. If it's a little bit too small, you can make it bigger or smaller. If I want to add some other things, so I might want to add, say for example, a grid just of the aspects, and I can just click on any of these items, they will come up with these little red squares, and you can just make them bigger or smaller. I mean, you go too small, it's just going to be ridiculous, but you can just move them around. And you can, some of the options are called flexible, which just means that you can add or subtract things to it. So if I select points list and insert, you can see it comes up with quite a big list. But if you click on it, you can right click and edit the flexible list columns, or you can go up here, object, edit flexible list columns. And these are all the options on the side that you can select from. So this has the point symbol, the longitude, daily travel, latitude, right ascension, declination, I can't even pronounce that, altitude, and points long symbol. So I'm going to save this. So save as, I'm just going to make it example. And save. What I find, and maybe this is me, maybe it's not so much solar fire, maybe it's something to do with me, but I find that when I first save as, so I'm making a new chart, it doesn't work for me. But if I'm editing something that's already there, it will work straight afterwards. Usually it will turn up in the added recently, but it doesn't look like we've got it here. So what I do, I just click out of it altogether and then just bring it back up again. Okay, where are we? Go back and bring that chart back up. So if we go in now, where are we? Go into added recently, we should have examples. Ah, there it is, example. So you can see this is quite small, so I would make that bigger. But this has a lot of information that you don't necessarily need, and you can see it's got both points. So what we're going to do, go into here, example, I'm going to edit it. I'm going to make this a little bit bigger, and you can just literally drag that so it's bigger. With this one, we're going to right click and edit. I'm going to get rid of that second point symbol, so you can see point symbol and points long symbol. If you want to get rid of something, you just click this here to send it back to that column. I don't need that. All that. Right ascension, I don't need that. I don't want that. What might I want? Just say I want to have the full name there. You can add that. So you can see if you've got something here and you want it in this column, you press that. If you've got something in this column and you want to get rid of it, you press that one. Once they are here, like if I want that point's full name just after the symbol, you just highlight it and then just move it up so you can see it's there now. You can see that shrunk quite a bit. You can check to see how many data lines. There's probably only 10. We have a look when we have a look in a minute. You can change that. I'll make that 12, which will make it massive, but just so you can see. File, save. Okay, so you can see that's quite big. You got the point, the name, the longitude, and the declination. The aspect grid is a little bit easier to see now. If we said, oh no, that's far too big, we could change that back to 12 or whatever. You can see that I've highlighted it here, but it's actually happening up here. Just click back here. And what else will we add? There's some things that you kind of couldn't or shouldn't add. For example, the zodiacal releasing. It will come up with four columns, like for each of the levels, but it only shows the first level. So it's a little bit of a waste including that on a chart. Or I think it is anyway. Maybe somebody else can do it better. So you can do nearest eclipses. Whatever you like. File, save, and apply. And if you decided that this was, you know, this is a chart, this is what you want to see every time you open a chart, and you get sick of going in and selecting it all the time, which you would, what you would do, you go to Preferences, Edit Settings, and if you go to Charts, or is it auto run? Houses. Okay, so it's view menu. So this is for the current chart. You can see there's dual wheels, bi wheels, tri wheels. You can select what you want for each one. So if you want the current chart, you can go in here and we can go and select. You can see I've got Hellenistic with bounds, but if we wanted to go to, where is it, the example, we just select that. Okay, and then any chart that I open after that, you can see it comes up with that. And I'm going to go back and change that. So that was Edit Settings. It was View Menu. It's for the current chart. which is anything that comes up here, and I'm going to change it back to Hellenistic with bounds. So you can see the chart comes up as I want it again. And that's kind of a basic overview of how you can go in and edit a chart. Or not a chart, but a page.